heading back over to the kitchen, and Joe nursing a little bit of a kitchen injury.
Yeah, geez. Yeah. Scalded myself on the GT Cruiser.
That little itty bitty grill packs a lot of clutch.
Yes. Man, it got me pretty good. You're not supposed to rub butter on it, though. It was on one of our butter medicines on News at 9.
That's right. You don't, on the wounds. Right. We're talking about, we're having a little grill off here this morning, and I brought in my grill. This is pretty big.
You want to brag about your grill?
You're a little scared. Yeah, and you've got that. Now, what were you making? What creations were you making this morning?
Well, I was making an omelet, a Southwest omelet, but I decided to change things up on you a little bit because you were making fun of the size of my grill.
Uh-huh.
So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to turn this into a breakfast burrito. And by the way, I didn't show you the best part of my grill.
Uh-huh.
Carrie, you might want to get a shot of that tool. Look at that tool that comes
with it. Camera guy, can you follow him? Yeah.
Look at that.
Mm-hmm.
That's a great
this
tool.
Is,
it's just a little tool, but it works. Pops it right out of there.
We need a new infomercial, King Joe.
Yeah,
can you recap can you recap your recipe for us?
Oh yeah, eggs, milk, cheese, red peppers, salt and pepper, tortilla now. Look at this.
And you just wrap it and go. Now you're going to double cook that?
Huh?
Can you double cook that?
Double cook, what are you talking about, Will?
You stuff it up and you stick it in this side. And you cook it again.
Yeah, right here.
I see. Yeah, I know. I watch the infomercials as well.
Oh, see?
Okay, now look. Now I got
bam.
I got something for you. Maybe you're looking for a dessert for your family and friends this holiday weekend, right?
It's getting a little messy,
folks. So we got thinking about grilling some desserts, and I went on the internet and found on the Food Network there was a recipe for some grilled fruit. So what we did is we skewered half a plum, a nectarine, and a peach. And what you do is you cut them in half, you pit them, and then you put 3 tablespoons of sugar on top of it. That gives you a little caramel glaze.
Yeah.
And you let the sugar sit and soak on the fruit for about 20 minutes. You put some nonstick spray on the surface of your grill because you don't want the fruit to get burned or anything, or stick like it's about to here. And then when it's time to go, when it's time to put it on, you put it on the grill for about 5 minutes. If you're going to use wooden skewers like I have here, you should soak them in water for a good 20 minutes to a half hour,
right,
especially if you use an open flame. But then when you're done, that's what the finished product looks like.
Oh, look at that. That actually does look pretty good.
That's what it looks like.
Gotta love a grilled peach.
And apparently the reviews on this website, if you go to foodnetwork.com, you look for the grilled fruit kebabs or whatever you call it. The rave reviews, I mean, people are saying it's a really healthy alternative. They're not going to go back to cake and ice cream anymore. They're going to do that.
Wow.
So we thought we'd share that with you this
morning. Well, that's pretty good.
Now, who's going to taste this?
This one's got plenty of fat.
Yes. And protein with the eggs.
And protein
and the cheese.
Eggs. It's very good. And I think I'm ready here. What do you think?
Are you going to do it?
Yeah. Who's our guinea pigs?
Yeah,
here?
Who are our taste testers?
We may need another segment.
Right, we need more time. We have to expand the newscast till 9:03, we think. You want to share that?
Yeah, I'll share that. We've had a huge catastrophe.
Did you see that? Did you happen to catch that?
Look at that.
Oh, no.
Can I just check out how unreliable the little tool was?
Yes.
I had so much confidence in the little tool.
You were a little nervous, though. You were a little bit nervous trying to get that out.
No, it's wavy. Well, we're still going to eat that.
Someone will eat
that. Yeah, because there's the 30-second rule. Oh, yeah. See, the interns are nodding. They're like, oh, yeah.
Yes, we know.
Here, let me scoop that back up. We don't want to. That's just bad TV leaving it down there. Like,
right. And bad housekeeping
there.
As well.
There we go.
Oh,
nothing
no.
wrong with that. That's going to be great.
Oh, man. Well, are we going to, do we have time to have them come in and taste?
Or do you want to do
ladies,
it now?
Come over.
Come on over, ladies.
Come on,
we're going to have you taste this.
Up.
I recommend mine. It's,
it's got that
fresh
nice,
minerals.
Yes, fiber, carpet fiber.
Does anybody have a fork?
No, we didn't come prepared. I have a spoon.
Maybe we need a...
You guys taste it. We'll go to break and we'll let you know how things taste when they come back. How about that? That's the plan.
That
be careful.
Good.
All right. Well, the nation's tallest building is presenting a new design. And if not for the faint of heart, of course.
Talking about the Sears Tower.
Yes.
They opened up some decks out there where you can stand out there and look straight down. It's like, look at that. Great view. It's coming up next. Hey, don't forget, if you are looking for something to do this 4th of July, we have a whole list of stuff on our website, coloradoconnection.com. There's some rolling across your screen right there. Have a happy and safe 4th of July, folks. Well, coming up Monday on Fox 21 Morning News, are you trying to squeeze the most out of your entertainment dollars? Our friends from the YMCA, they'll be here to show us how to have family fun on a budget. Also, after weeks of posing for the cameras, we'll announce the winners of the Colorado Springs Cutest Kid Photo Contest. And saddle up, the rodeo's in town, and we kick off a week of all things rodeo with a preview of the big parade downtown. And all that, plus your weather and traffic together on the twos, starting bright and early. 6 a.m. I won't actually be here for that one, Tim, because I think I've worn out my welcome as far as cooking goes.
Yeah, you're not allowed to cook for us anymore. These are our interns. Introduce yourselves.
Well, I'm Crystal Moyer.
And I'm Danielle DeSilvio.
Okay, very good. And you guys had these wonderful items placed in front of you. And under the pressure and lights of television, we're going to actually ask you who wins this wonderful event.
Well, I personally like the fruit, and I think that Tim should get some style points because it looks really pretty.
But thank you.
Great, we're getting fruit points for pretty.
I choose the omelet. I think the floor hairs gave it a little oomph.
That's right. See? Right.
Oomph. Oddly enough, you need a little hair. Yes,
yeah,
exactly. To jazz your life up a little bit.
It certainly wasn't my hair on the omelet.
Right, exactly. Thanks, ladies, for all your help this morning. We're going to have the recipe on our website, coloradoconnection.com, a little bit later on this morning if you want to check that out. Make it for your friends. Of course, if you'd like all the news, latest news and weather information for the weekend, we've got that interactive Doppler radar. You'll check it on our website, coloradoconnection.com.
Have a great 4th.
Thank you for watching Fox 21.